First of all, congratulations. How was your preparation and what was your initial goal for the World Championships this year?
Yeah, preparation was actually really, really good. I couldn't compete because I was coming back from an injury and there was no competitions before the World Championships. So I just said, okay, I'll take an extra month, 5 weeks to prepare just for the World and to come back and fight the World as my first competition back since my surgery in April. So I would say it's gone pretty well.
At your repechage, you were down by, well, it's 2-1 penalties, but you were the one under pressure. So how did you feel? Because, of course, it is putting athletes under pressure. But what I always say is that this is could be that pressure could come out and as a positive impact. Was that the case in your case?
Yeah, I felt like I was getting frustrated with myself in the repechage fight because I felt like I could throw her, but at the same time, this is the first time I fought her, so I wasn't sure kind of what else she could have up her sleeve, so I didn't want to do anything risky. But I felt kind of the last minute that I was really starting to edge back the fight, and just before the golden score, I was actually, you know, ready to kind of execute my techniques. And then as soon as the golden score started, I just felt it was right to do that technique.
Against your opponent and Miriam Roper, you had you fought each other four occasions. It was 2-2 before this bronze medal contest. So having to defeat her before, but also losing her against, of course, did it give you any confidence that you know you've beaten her before? So the job could have been done. And we're talking about a world bronze. So what was going through your head?
In my head, it was I have nothing to lose, only to gain. And I haven't had the competition experience this year because of all my injuries, and I still feel like I'm developing. But at the same time, I kind of felt that Miriam's had her time to win a lot of world bronze medals, and it's about time that I won one. So I just thought, just go out there and do my judo and then see what happens. Stay in the fight until the last minute and last second, really, and see what happens. Yeah.
Great. And to close this interview, that's the first medal for Great Britain, and yeah, I just would like to know your overall feelings about the fact that you won the first one, and that's your first as well.
I think it feels crazy because today I just said it's my first competition at 57 since the Olympics. That's over a year ago, and I just said I have nothing to lose today, only to gain. You know, I either win today or I learn. There's no losing today. So I just thought I'm fit. I'm probably one of the fittest here. It's rare that you can turn up to a championships with no injuries, and I've had my fair share. I thought, you've had enough bad times now. It's time for you to have some fun and to have some good times. And I just really felt like I deserved it today, and that gave me confidence. So yeah, I had nothing to lose. Sometimes when you have nothing to lose, you fight even better. Yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, and congratulations again.